Hi, we're here at NAB 2018 at the Post Perspective booth, and I'm here today with Neill Barham, CEO of Filmic Pro, the mobile app movie maker. Neill, can you tell me, how did you come to create this app and why is it so special?
I came to conceive of the app around the launch of the iPhone 4, which was the first smartphone to shoot high definition video. Only 720p at the time, didn't have image stabilization. But if you use a tripod or kept it stable leaning up against a door jamb per se, then you had a really compelling high definition image that I thought you'd be able to cut into a larger scale production, potentially as a B-roll camera. The more I stewed on that concept, the idea was if it's good enough to be a B-roll shot in a professional production, then it's certainly going to be good enough for most people's video camera, handy cam use case scenario. So now we sort of have a foot in each camp. Broadcast production for, I guess, the adventurous or the mobile-minded, and then for the consumer, it's with them at all times, so it gives them more control, but if anything comes up in the moment, they can capture it as the best of their ability.
If you had to pick three features of your app that say better than iMovie, what would you say?
Higher bit rate for sure, so you get more information. Your image isn't going to degrade as much as you go through various post processes than if you want to color grade it. And then customization. If you want to shoot in any sort of widescreen aspect ratio or an Instagram ratio, you can do that. And then frame rates. We were the first camera to shoot 24 frames per second. So if you're trying to achieve the film look, or if you're in Europe or another 25 frame per second market, we can offer that to an end user as well.
That's great. Tell me a little bit about the Stephen Soderberg story with Unsane. How did that come to be?
I think he got enamored with Sean Baker's Tangerine. We didn't hear about the production until it was leaked in the press in November that he had made a feature film with an iPhone. And certainly knew that we would potentially be in the running for the app that he might use, but we hadn't heard from them. So we thought that that's either a really good sign or potentially not a good sign. But then when the feature film debuted at Berlinale in the electronic press kit, they talked about not only using Filmic Pro, but also using Filmic Remote, which lets you control Filmic Pro on a device, whether it's on a jib arm or car mount dolly or inside a glove compartment, any sort of unusual camera placement, and then control it wirelessly. And Steven apparently really liked that level of ingenuity that it enabled him to do.
Did he use your proprietary codec as well, that high resolution codec?
Yep, yeah, Filmic Extreme is what we call it.
That's the one. Why is that so special?
It's just twice the information that you get with the native camera app, and so in his case, when they blow it up to 40 feet on a big theatrical screen, you're not gonna see the pixelation and you're not gonna see the image wash out when you do extensive color grading. Which actually, I don't think that he's as stylistically motivated in color grading his image. We've heard from some people on his team that he likes to see what he's going to get when he's shooting on set.
I understand you're also working with DJI. Can you tell me about that collaboration and working relationship?
Sure. They reached out to us before the launch of the Osmo Mobile One, and we did an integration where you can control the functionality within our app or the pan tilt controls that the Osmo offers any end user by cycling through modes that are on the handset, so you don't actually have to touch the screen or the interface and impair any movement. They've subsequently come out with the Osmo Mobile 2, which is about half the price of the original, has some actually unique features that are in some ways better than the original, and we're about to launch support for that as well. And we actually have some other interesting third-party integrations coming in the next few months, so be on the lookout for those.
In just a few quick seconds, what have you seen here at NAB that's got you excited?
Too much. I guess the Blackmagic Pocket camera actually we think is a really interesting, compelling product at a price point that's a bit above ours, but certainly going to be approachable for a lot of people. Native Super 35 sensor, I think, is fantastic.
That's great. Well, thank you very much.
Thank you so much. It's been a pleasure chatting with you.
And we're back here again. So that was, again, Filmic Pro. If you need more information, filmicpro.com, right?
You got it.
All right.